Hey guys, welcome back to another episode. So today I am here with another book review, The Big Question of Life by the Ohm Swami. So when this book is like, this book is also recently released around 21, last month of 21. So I was eagerly waiting for this book because I have almost read more than 5 to 6 books by the Ohm Swami. I have put those videos on the YouTube channel. You can check all this video about the Ohm Swami books. The kind of books Ohm Swami gives, the kind of knowledge he shares, it's completely new, it's completely valuable. So I thought, let's try with this book. So when I read The Big Question of Life, so I have this mixed feeling for this book. It's a kind of, you know, balanced feeling, not completely, you know, completely 5-star rating and not completely 2-star rating. So I have a mixed feeling for this book. You know, one of the best part about the Ohm Swami book is the storytelling skills, the way he share the knowledge, the way he talk about the things, the way he talk about the life in the storytelling format. I mean, whenever we have something question or so, if you have read almost all these books, Mindful to Mindful, The Wellness Forever, the Kindness Success, so The Hurt of Success, so you will realize that he talk in the story. I mean, whether this is a question or even if he wants to give something lesson, then he always talk in the form of story, so we can consume that better and we can get the knowledge in a better way. The same process also in this book, The Big Question About the Life. So this book is also talk about the storytelling format. This book is also divided into stories. I mean, every has, like, from the life to the bond to the death, everything you talk about in this book. This book is kind of a philosophical, it's not like a complete practical guide. You will get some idea, you will get some philosophical knowledge, you will get some idea about how to see the life. So it's more about talk about the life. Like, we say that death is certain, but what about life? Life is not certain, life is unpredictable. Whatever can happen with your life, whatever can happen in the next moment. So how we deal with that, how to suffer, how to get out of that suffering, and how to go from suffering to the happiness. So if you want to find all of these questions, then you have to read this book. So there is a reason why I have mixed feeling for this book, because in this book there is no kind of like practical guides. This book is more about the philosophical stuff. I know philosophy is important in life, but this book is more of a kind of a philosophy, and if you enjoy philosophy, then you will definitely enjoy this book. This book is divided into 4 parts: samsara, loneliness, self, and awakening. So you can see that we are going from the understanding everything, then what is loneliness, then what is self, and how to go from suffering to happiness. So this kind of all stuff in this book you will find it. So when I first read, if you have read all these books, so whenever Ohm Swami divided the book, then he always divided into the 3 parts, but this time we have around 4 parts. So the first topic, which is the samsara, I mean, I because of that context or because of the society, whatever we had, I first read as a samsara. So when I read this, the first chapter, the first chapter is ABC of life. You will understand that why, what is life, how you should think about life, and how you should deal with the life. I mean, you have a lot of questions about the life. So if you want to find the answer, then the first chapter is for you, where you talk about everything about the life. I'm not going to give you what is in the book or what are the things you will get out of this book. So for that you have to read this book. So first part is all about the understanding life. So these also divided into story parts. So in every chapter, in the first chapter or in the book, every chapter starts with the one question about the life, about understanding, and the chapter is revolves around that question. And this is the good, I mean, this is the really good composition of this book. I mean, you will first understand that, okay, this chapter is going to talk about this question. So you will, and at the end of that chapter, you will understand that what is that question. So first one is talk about the ABC of life. The samsara is more about the understanding everything around us. The second part is loneliness. What is loneliness? Why we suffer? How to get out of that loneliness? What exactly loneliness? How we structure loneliness in our mind? So this kind of stuff in the second part you will find it. The third part is known as the self. So you can see that there is a pattern. First you will understand what is society, what are the different questions we have, then understanding the loneliness, what is loneliness, how to understand the loneliness, what is the price of the freedom, how to get that freedom. So this kind of thing you will understand in the second part. The third part is self, understanding yourself, how how you will understand yourself, what is the self-awareness, or what is the thing about yourself. Like, there is a quote or there is a saying goes around the world that why good people suffer. Like, you must have heard that good people always suffer, but why do they suffer? There is a reason. So you will get this answer in this, the third part, that self understanding yourself, the third part of this book that is called the self. There is a chapter in this book that why good people suffer. So you will have to read this book if you want to understand that why good people suffer. So the last part is awakening, where you will understand how you can go from the suffering to the happiness. First you will understand suffering, then you can turn that into the happiness. So you will, most of the content you will find in the last two parts, the self and the awakening, where you will understand much reality. You will understand much better way that how to deal with the life, how to deal with the suffering, what is happiness, and all those kind of stuff. So the reason I personally believe that Om Swami is a really, really good guy. If you have read this previous book, if you have read the Mindful to Mindful and the Heart of Success, when you talk about the business, he's really good. But this book is kind of a mixed feelings I have, because this more of a kind of a philosophical book. There is no kind of a guidance at the end of the chapter. There is no kind of practical tips. It's just that understanding what is life and how you can deal with the life, how you can deal with the suffering, how to go for the happiness. So if you are looking for the philosophical read, if you are looking for the quick read, because this book is hardly 150 to 200 pages, and you will get it on the Kindle right now, because this Kindle edition is out on the last month of 20. So if you want to read it, if you want to understand what is life, what is death, what is pain, what is the suffering, what is happiness, then you can read this book. Or if you are a fan of Om Swami book, if you have consumed a lot of content from the Om Swami, then I will highly suggest you to read this book, because you will get to know a lot of things clear. And even if you are new to the philosophy, then I will suggest you that if you want to understand in a much better way, if you want to understand in a much simpler format, then this book you can definitely pick up. There is other books also, I have made a review on the other books of the Om Swami also. You can check the playlist in my channel. So I guess that's the reason I have a mixed feelings for this book. If you have enjoyed, if you want to read philosophical stuff, a short read, then go pick up this book, The Big Question of Life. There is a link in the description. Go buy this book. So that's all for the today's video. If you are new to this channel, subscribe, press the bell icon, because I post a lot of new stuff. I post about the marketing, I talk about the freelancing and a lot of new things. So if you are new, subscribe. And if you are new, go to the Instagram and follow me. I post a lot of content on the Instagram also. That's all for the today's video. See you in the next one. Bye-bye.